Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop Podcast. So unless you completely blinked and slept through the very beginning of this show, well then you probably don't have an idea what's going on. So it's time for Router Bit of the Month. That's right, once again, the great folks over at WoodCraft and Whiteside Machine Company totally set us up over here. They sent us another great router bit to try out, and for one of you lucky listeners slash viewers, you're going to get a chance to win this. So anyways, what router bit do we have? Well, as always, WoodCraft picks one of the great profiles that Whiteside Machine Company has in their extensive collection, and they put it on sale for the entire month so that people like us can head over to the WoodCraft store near us, if you're lucky enough to have one, or you can order it online by maybe clicking on the links at mattsbasementworkshop.com, which will take you right to it. But anyways, though, no matter how you get a hold of it, they put it on sale for the entire month, and it's definitely worth picking up. So it's a nice way to add a few more router bits to your collection without necessarily breaking the bank. So which router bit do we have? Well, obviously, as you take a look at this, this is a dovetail bit. Now, this is a 14-degree angle on this dovetail bit, and from what I found, it tends to be the most common angle that you're going to use in just about all the pre-manufactured dovetail jigs. Now, the one nice thing about this, as always with Whiteside Machine Company, is this is a solid bit. Now, really, if you take a look at it, I'm going to do this careful, it's sharp. This is a 2-inch in total length. It's a 1/4-inch shank, and the nice thing is you got these two flutes, one, two, and those two flutes are going to really result in some nice, clean, crisp dovetails, basically, both the tails and the actual sockets or the pins, if that's what you want to call them. You're going to get some nice, clean, crisp results with it, so you're not going to be so concerned with tarot, which unfortunately it seems like the majority of dovetail jigs that are out there, the manufacturer, the router bit that either comes with it or the one that they recommend for it, tends to not exactly be the best one in the world. So if you have one that you're not so thrilled with, this one from Whiteside Machine Company, I'm going to highly suggest that maybe if you get an opportunity, especially for the entire month of October, you could head over and pick this one up. And even when, you know, the month is over and it goes back to its regular price, it's totally worth the money. So anyways, like I said, we got 2 inches in length, 1/4-inch shank, we've got the two flutes, and the nice thing, just like all the router bits that we've had a chance to try out here, it's carbide tipped. So you know what that means. It's going to be a long time between sharpenings, and given the size that, you know, you can see that piece of carbide on there. That is a nice thick piece of carbide. So you're going to get a lot of sharpenings out of this one. It's going to last you for quite a while. Now, the nice thing about these 14-degree angles is that I found for myself, it gives a very, very dramatic flair to it. Maybe that's why most commercial jigs really like the look of it. And I have actually seen where a lot of people feel that with the 14-degree, it's better to use this primarily with half-blind dovetails versus the through. And I'm not really sure why that is. As I had mentioned in the audio show, I'm sure it has a lot to do with tradition. Traditionally, the dovetails, like in softwood, it's recommended to be like a 6 to 7 degree angle. So essentially that's half the steepness. Or with hardwoods, it's usually more of an 8 degree. But anyways, regardless of which one you use, the 14 degree is definitely a very dramatic flair to it. And it looks wonderful. Now, what I want to do next is since there's really not too much to describe about it. I mean, it's a basic dovetail bit, but as always, Whiteside Machine Company makes them really, really strong, and they make them really, really, really to last when it comes down to it. Let's actually go into some demonstrations of the router bit in action. Okay, so the one demonstration that I do want to do for you today is I actually want to make a sliding dovetail. Now, the one thing is, when it comes down to it, a sliding dovetail is really nothing more than a modified tongue groove. It's just simply that rather than having a tongue with the corresponding groove, we now have a shaped groove and a shaped tongue is what it really comes down to. So we're going to take our first piece of stock, which is this 3/4-inch piece. It's 3/4 inch wide, and we are actually going to create the socket with the dovetail, and it'll go the full entire length of this. And the most important thing is we want to know, first of all, since this is 3/4 inch, and we know for a fact that our router bit has a maximum diameter of 1/2 inch, that means that if we center it as close to perfect as we can, we have essentially 1/8 inch on either side. It's a little weak, but once you get the whole thing put together, it will actually strengthen itself up to some degree. Really, when it comes down to it, this is more, again, kind of a decorative type of a feature. But again, in a situation where you want the movement that a tongue and groove can offer, this will give you a little extra strength, though, when it comes down to it. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm actually going to mark out where the dovetail is going to go in, where the socket is going to be created. We'll do that at the router table next, and then we'll come back and take a look at it, and we'll move on to the next part.
Okay, as you notice, I went ahead and put a groove right down the center already, and I highly suggest this to get the best results from your dovetail bit. And mainly, it has a lot to do with the fact that it'll keep the motor from being overtaxed, and number two, it's going to give you a little bit longer life on the dovetail bit itself. You could do the entire groove with just the dovetail, but you're going to notice it's going to be really kind of hard to push through, and it just, like I said, you're going to notice a lot of stress on your motor. Now, one more thing is it would be a lot more helpful if I were to use feather boards to hold it in place, so I highly suggest if you have a chance, do that.
All right, so we're back from the router table, and essentially what we have here is our nicely centered dovetail socket, and it runs the entire length. Now, as you saw in the video, I actually ran it through the first time, then I flipped it over and ran it back through it in the opposite direction, and that made sure that I got my dovetail as close to perfectly centered as possible, which is going to be very, very important for when you go to make the corresponding tail, which is what we're going to do next. We're going to head over to the table, and we'll go ahead and make it from there.
Now, when it comes to cutting the tail itself, this is probably the easiest part. Just do a couple of test fits ahead of time, do a nice slow feed rate, and of course here is where feather boards really come in handy. Now watch your fingers on the back side, because again, if you're working with narrower stock, it's potentially you could unfortunately have it in the wrong spot, so think safety.
Okay, it went really simple. Basically, again, we just pushed it through right up against the fence, and then we turned it around, did the other side. And it's very important that when you are doing these, of course, you'll always do test cuts with any type of specialized joinery or any type of special cut that you're going to be doing. But especially when it comes to a sliding dovetail, it's more important to oversize the cut and then sneak up on it. What you didn't see was me making several cuts to make sure I got the right one so that it would look perfect for you guys. But as you can see, we have a perfectly formed dovetail right there. And we'll grab the corresponding piece, we'll put them together, and see, it just fits in like that. And again, it's not, it could be a little bit snugger, but it's not too bad, snugger. And anyways, that's what we have, is now we have a sliding dovetail. And again, gives you a lot of strength there. You've got some mobility in it. Like I said, if it was a little bit more snug, it would fit really nice. It's, you know, but essentially still, you get all the benefits of the long grain to long grain, but you have that little extra strength in there. And seriously, doesn't that look pretty neat right there? So anyways, though, that pretty much is the dovetail, the sliding dovetail.
Now what I have here is I just wanted to have an example of a through dovetail that I use to actually join my drawer rails to some of the structural members in this dresser that I had built for my wife and I. And this is what I was talking about how beautiful they can really be. And this one takes a little play to get it just the right way. And I actually have a jig, which I promise I will do for a upcoming jig of the week. But this is one of the great things that you can do with dovetails.
All right, well, I hope that helped you out with what you could possibly do with the dovetail. Like I said, I don't have a decent dovetail jig, so it's not really worth me mounting this up and pretending like I do. I highly recommend that you head over to the Wood Whisperer and check out Mark's video, you know, dovetails. And, of course, the sliding dovetail, very easy to make. And there is the one other version that, I showed you the quick picture of it and everything with the little voiceover. That's another really great one, too. And you can get all those great results with this baby right here, the 14-degree dovetail bit from Whiteside Machine Company. Like I said, it's on sale at WoodCraft for the entire month of October. It's a really great one to pick up. So if you have any comments, questions, suggestions, want to enter your name in for the free swag, drop me a line at mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com or head over to mattsbasementworkshop.com where you'll find a link to WoodCraft. I want to congratulate our winner this week of the 14-degree angle dovetail bit, and that is Brian Burritt. So congratulations, Brian. I'm getting a hold of you, and hopefully this is going to be on your way by the time this video is getting posted. So anyways, though, I'd like to thank everybody for stopping by, and once again, thanks to the great folks over at WoodCraft and Whiteside Machine Company. So until the next time, I'll be talking to you straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.